water went and earth went down. Then Brahma started thinking, what do I do? People have to live on the earth, so I have to save people now. Then he was thinking so seriously and he was praying to Vishnu. He was praying constantly and suddenly, out of his nostrils, he saw a small boar. He was surprised to see that the boar was also having a mix of, it was a mix of boar and human. Then in front of his eyes, that small baby grew into a big man. Then he thought, oh, this is the avatar of Lord Vishnu. Then as soon as he grew up, he leapt into the water. He took the earth and he started swimming. He was now on a mission to put the earth in a safe place above the water level. Then he was going. On the other hand, there was a devil who was the king of all the devils. His name was Hiranyaksh. So he was thinking, where these gods were coming and fighting with me? Then he went to the god of seas. Rishi, who is the god of seas? It is Varaha. So he went to Varaha and asked, why are people not coming and fighting with me? Then Varaha said, all other gods except Vishnu are not capable to fight with you. Then Hiranyaksha said, then why doesn't he come and fight with me? Then suddenly, from behind, there was a person who comes everywhere. Exactly, it was Narada. So he came. He was like instigating a war. So he said, Narayana, Narayana. He is in the form of a Varaha and is hiding under the water. So that Hiranyaksha feels that he is afraid. I wish he is afraid of the Hiranyaksha. Then he says, okay, now I have to go and fight with him. He leaps into the water immediately. Then he sees, he calls out, oh Vishnu, where are you? Come fight with me, O coward. Then, but Vishnu doesn't hear. He was on a mission, I told, right? To put the earth above the water. So he was going. At last he completed his mission to put it above the surface. He turned back and to his surprise, there was Hiranyaksha. Hiranyaksha was ready to attack on Vishnu with his large gadha. He went and then what happens? Vishnu takes the gadha with his leg and with the other leg he kicks
Kayak.
She was actually carrying a baby. Then Narad comes and tells, I will take her because she has to be taken care. Then Hiranyakashipu continues his tapasya. Narad starts telling the tales of gods to Kayathu, which in turn is heard by the baby in her stomach. Then what happens? After a lot of days of tapasya, finally Lord Rama comes in front of Hiranyakashipu. He asks, what do you want? Why are you doing so poor tapasya to me? And then he is like, oh Lord Brahma, give me the powers that I'll be immortal. Nobody will kill me. Even if they kill me, I'll not die. Then Brahma says, no, that is not possible. Then Hiranyakashipu thinks for a while and says, okay, fine. Oh Lord Brahma, give me such a boon that neither a man nor an animal should kill me. I should not be killed outside or inside. I should not be killed in the morning or in the evening. Then Brahma says, he smiles and he says, Tadastu. And then he goes away. Then Hiranyakashipu gets to know that all of his people are taken. Then Hiranyakashipu goes there and he starts defeating the gods, and he brings back his men. And he even brings back his wife Kayathu. He gets to know that he has a son now, named Prahlad. So he brings him back also. Prahlad was always chanting the name of Lord Vishnu. Why? Because he was from before told that Lord Vishnu was the greatest of all. Then he was always chanting. Hiranyakashipu got really very angry. And he was really very fed up hearing, oh Lord Vishnu, oh Lord Vishnu. He told, I am also a god, chant my name. Then Prahlad said, no, you are not a god. Lord Vishnu is a god. Then he was really angry. So what he did, he loved his son, but still he told his guards to, he made his son suffer. He put him in a cage of where snakes were there. He was made to drink poison. And Prahlad used to happily go through chanting the name of Vishnu. So every time he used to come out. So then one day Hiranyakashipu was really very vexed up. He says, now I have to deal with him. Then he brings in Prahlad and asks, okay, you say that your god is the greatest, but if I defeat your god, will you start chanting my name as your god? Then Prahlad says, that is not possible. You can't do that. You can't defeat Lord Vishnu. Then he says, okay, fine. Let him come. Where is he? Let him come and fight with me. Where is he? Then Prahlad says a very thing that became very famous. I don't know that much tell you, that's why. Indu Ganadu, Andu Ledu, Ani Sandehapu Valadu. What does it mean, Rishi? I know you. Come on.
No doubt that he's in here, not there.
Where?
He's everywhere.
Okay. So then Hiranyakashipu becomes really very angry now. He says, okay, he's everywhere. Is he in this pillar? He says, yes. Is he not? Do you have any doubt? Hiranyakashipu is at high peaks of anger. He takes his gada and breaks that pillar. And out of it comes Narasimha Swami, whose head was a lion's and body was that of a human's. Then he drags Hiranyakashipu to the door of his palace and puts him on his thigh and just takes, like with his claws, he tears his skin and he dies. Then what happens? Now all the three conditions are fulfilled. He's not even killed by a man or an animal. He's not killed inside or outside. He's killed in So that is the end of the third.